So your revised book follows more extensive research on your part. So what are the facts?
Well, you know, the film for me became quite personal. There were some people called it, say that I was an accomplice to Ray Santilli, that I was in his, you know, I was being paid to assist him and so on. None of which was true. So I set off, I made the decision that in public, Dean, or to Ray Santilli's face or in private with him, I would support him. You know, I would say it's authentic. You know, we can do this, that, and the other. But behind the scenes, I was working with colleagues in different parts of the world to try and get to the bottom of it, whatever that may be. Little did I know it would take a lot longer than it did, but slowly but surely, we chipped away at things. For example, the first piece of film he showed us, we got the nickname the tent footage. It claims it's filmed in the desert in a field tent. I got a tip off that a certain company had made it. I found that company, although it had closed, but I found the people who worked there. They admitted it. Yes, we made the tent footage. We presented it to Ray Santilli, and he said, go away and come back with something better. But we didn't make the autopsy film. We made the tent footage. Ray came up with a story to try and explain that away. So slowly but surely, we chipped away at it. Then we got another tip off. Is there any interest still in the alien autopsy film? This was around about 2003. Why? This was on email. Well, my friend made the dummies for it. So wow. I met this gentleman. I met him. He explained that his friend, very good friend of his, made the dummies for it, but he wouldn't tell us who it was. However, in explaining who his friend was, he let out a little bit of information by accident. And using that tiny fragment, we were able to discover who this gentleman was. Now, he wasn't a special effects expert. He's actually a sculptor. Royal Academy trained sculptor, and his name was John Humphreys. So we contacted John Humphreys, and he was going to go public about this, and he spoke to a chap by the name of Robert Kiviat. Robert Kiviat is the man who made Alien Autopsy Fact or Fiction. He's the producer, and he was discussing it with Bob, and he mentioned another name. He said, it's not me you need to be speaking to. It's Spiros. But no second name, just Spiros. Anyway, John Humphreys, like others, disappeared into the background because Ray Santilli was now making a movie called Alien Autopsy. Guess who was doing the special effects? John Humphreys.
Right.
So we had this first name, Spiros, but nothing else. And then, out of the blue in 2006, a colleague of mine who used to edit his own UFO magazine, a chap by the name of Russell Callahan. I've known Russell a long time. We made a little video about the alien autopsy. We interviewed a few people. DVD, I should say now. And he got a telephone call. And Russ said to this chap, well, it's not me you need to be speaking to. I think it's Philip. So pass the details on to me. And the gentleman who wanted to speak to us was Spiros Malaris. As soon as I heard the name Spiros, what are the odds it means a different Spiros? It's not a very common name.
No.
I spoke to Spiros just by chance. I have the tapes of our conversation I've just dug out. And he filled in all the gaps, Dean. Spiros, by profession, was a filmmaker. And a magician, still a magician now. He had his own TV studio at one point that he used to lease out to whoever. As a young man, he trained as a mechanic as well. So he had a lot of strings to his bows. And he told us the story of how he bumped into Ray Santilli in 1995. Santilli told him this fake story, showed him the tent footage, and Spiro says, if he wants an alien autopsy film, I can make you some. me and my friend John Humphreys. So that's what he set about doing. The actual set, you know, the autopsy operating theatre was in Spiros's sister's apartment. Again, just by chance, she was having it renovated at the time, so it didn't make any difference what kind of mess they made. Now, the reason there's two autopsies is because the first one they made a mistake. It was a mistake with one of the medical procedures. It was spotted by Spiros's girlfriend at the time, and she said, if you show that, game's up straight away. So John Humphreys still had the mold for the dummy. He cast another one that night, but again, there was a mistake with it the following morning. When you see it, there's a big wound in the leg. Well, there was an air pocket in the leg. So right. They improvised. They went to the butchers and got some bones, put the bones in it, and burnt it a little bit, you know, like a lot of special effects people do. They improvise. They filmed it. And that's the one that has been shown on the television around the world. They also made the wreckage. Now, Spiros is of Greek origin, so he not only speaks Greek, but he reads and writes it as well. So when you see the wreckage, there's some large I-beams on it, and there's markings down the side of it. They're actually part Greek.
Wow.
So we just sort of fiddled with them a little bit, but they are Greek in origin. And but the difference is, Spiros says the idea that they had wasn't to sell this as the genuine article. It's to put it out there and say, we don't know what this is. But then six months, 9 months down the line, stand up and say, da-da, you know, we made it. In the hope that they would get some more work, you know, John Humphreys, as his sculptor, would get some more work and so on. But every time they went to Sam Tilly, he kept saying, well, I haven't made my money back yet. You know, I paid a lot of money for this fake tent footage. So Spiros just forgot all about it, just went about his, you know, his life.
Yeah.
And was astonished in 2006 when he heard about the movie being made. And he looked online and he just couldn't believe it, you know, what had happened. And of course, you know, the game was up. Ray then changed his story, saying, well, it's the film deteriorated and we had to make a restoration. But if you're doing a restoration, Dean, why do you make two films?
Yeah.
Well, you don't, do you?
No. I just wanted to establish the fact, so there may be actual real footage of a real alien autopsy that took place back, none at all?
None at all.
So
absolutely non-zilch.
Okay, so the I was reading the other day where it was suggested that the film was a reconstruction of footage that Santilli saw.
Well, this is where Ray changed his story, you see.
Yeah.
Like I said, on the pamphlet he put out selling his video, he said on there that what you see is the actual footage, all of it. It's not all there, but then we go back to the gentleman that made the tent footage, and I said, well, where did you get the idea to make the tent footage? I said, from Ray Santilli.
Wow. So bottom line is that you believe that the wrong people asked the wrong questions when the email discussion surfaced.
That's right. Yeah. I mean, you know, I was sent the emails a day before they appeared online. You know, they arrived totally out of the blue. It's an 11-page email thread. And in that time frame, US billionaire Bigelow had his own company called National Institute of Discovery Sciences, NIDS. And he employed a number of scientists to investigate, research the UFO subject on his behalf. And one of those was Dr. Christopher Kit Green. And Kit Green had previously been employed by the CIA. And so this email thread is basically clarifying some of Kit's comments that he'd made. And one of which was that in 1987, stroke 88, he'd been called to the Pentagon for a briefing. And there he was shown an autopsy video that was, quote, the same as the Alien Autopsy that was released in 1995. He also went on to give his, because he is a medical doctor, went on to give his own medical opinion on the Alien Autopsy film. And he even comments at the end as if he's actually spoken to some of Santilli's staff. He makes comments about his PR people. And even I get a mention in it as well. Mm-hmm. Apparently I helped put them in touch with Ray Santilli. The point being that there is no way that he could see something in 1987, excuse me, that looked that's the same as something made in 1995.
Right.
Now, Richard Dolan got hold of Kick Green and interviewed him. He then changed his mind and said, well, we don't believe the alien autopsy is real. And I believe that the film I was shown by the CIA was fake as well. However, he says, bits of it were the same as the Santilli film in 1995. Well, whether it's all of it or bits of it, mm-hmm. it simply cannot be, because the film released in 1995 not only wasn't released then, but wasn't conceived and designed and made until 1995. Now, I managed to get hold of Kit Green on email, not on the telephone, and he gave me a comment. I also got hold of one of the other gentlemen named in the email list. A few of the other scientists are all copied in on it. He doesn't want his name mentioning, but he said, oh, we've, you know, this email, they both confirmed that this email thread is authentic. It's not a fake. But they've changed their minds now. They don't believe the film was real.
Right.
But of course, Santilli jumped on the bandwagon and he said, I knew there'd be documents would prove my film is real. But it doesn't.
No, no.